Welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to prepare a dish which is very close to my heart. And it's the steak tartare. It's a very famous dish in France and in Belgium. It's a raw meat dish. It's not going to be for everybody, but with millions of people eating it in France and Belgium weekly, it is really a treat. So for my steak tartare, I've been using the same ingredients for the past 10 years and I'm not changing it anymore. To me, it's the perfect steak tartare. We're gonna use some lean meat. Most people use fillet, but you can also use any cut you want as long as it's lean. You don't want to be chewing through fat. This is sirloin. And we're gonna be using steaks about 6-7 ounces is enough for one portion. Then we got some shallots, some capers, one anchovy per steak tartare, some mustard, some mayo, some black pepper, some salt. We're going to be using an egg yolk per steak tartare. And then we got some Tabasco and some mustard sauce. So for the steak tartare, I find it very important that you cut it by hand. So we're just going to cut this as fine as possible. We start by cutting strips. And just a tip is put your thumb behind your fingers so you can't cut them. All you can do is hit your nails. Once they're in fine strips, just turn it around and do the same in the other direction. Just keep cutting it, bring it back together and then cut it again. That's enough. I don't want it to cut too fine. Want a little bit of bite to it. In a bowl. Capers. I've got two tablespoons of capers here. Make sure you squeeze out the vinegar, as the vinegar will actually cook the meat. We give these a quick chop as well. Again, we don't really want everything too fine. A nice size shallot for two steaks. Anchovy, two anchovies. Again, give them a nice chop. In the tartare. Then one tablespoon of mustard, good quality Dijon mustard in this case. A good tablespoon of mayo. Some pepper, some salt, a good dash of Worcester sauce, and just a few drops of Tabasco. We give this a good stir. Until everything's nicely mixed. And you want to do this last minute. You can't really keep steak tartare very long. So maybe do it 10-15 minutes before you want to serve it. And then just keep it in the fridge. It's important to serve it ice cold. So at this point you can either put the egg yolks inside or serve them on top. I'm just going to put them on top here, so I'm going to take half my steak tartare. I'm just going to shape it a little bit on my board. Just make it into a nice patty. you have a metal ring to do this. Works perfectly. Put it on my plate. I'm gonna make a little dent with the egg. Split the egg. And just put the egg yolk on top. What else could we possibly be serving with it? And some fries. And some more mayo. And there you have it. Steak tartare.